Everybody, it's me again, Pastor Renee, here for All Saints Sunday, and it's been a good Sunday. I'm actually recording this sermon after I've delivered it in all three churches, which is not my usual practice, but it's been a very hectic and stressful week for our family, as my husband has been in AFib all week. So he's not been able to walk from room to room without getting winded and such. So I ask that you pray for him and pray for all of us as we're, in that time of our life of, dealing with the fears of the what ifs and all that. And so we ask for prayers. But luckily, we've been blessed today that he's able to walk from room to room without being winded, and we're grateful for that, and we hope that means that he's got some smooth sailing ahead. So there's that to hope for. But let's get into scripture for today. It's from Luke chapter 20, verses 27 through 38. Some Sadducees, those who say there is no resurrection, came to him, meaning Jesus, and asked him a question. Teacher, Moses wrote for us that if a man's brother dies, leaving a wife but no children, the man shall marry the widow and raise up children for his brother. Now there were seven brothers. The first married and died childless. Then the second and the third married her, and so in the same way all seven died childless. Finally, the woman also died. In the resurrection, therefore, whose wife will the woman be? Anyway, for the seven had married her. Jesus said to them, those who belong to this age marry and are given in marriage, but those who are considered worthy of a place in that age and in the resurrection from the dead neither marry nor are given in marriage. Indeed, they cannot die any more, because they are like angels and are children of God, being children of the resurrection. And the fact that the dead are raised Moses himself showed in the story about the bush, where he speaks of the Lord as the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Now he is God, not of the dead, but of the living, for to him all of them are alive. Here ends today's reading. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. And so we learn a couple things from our scripture reading today. One thing that I learned is I'm glad that sometimes traditions change. And I'm not saying anything bad about my brothers-in-law. But, I married Shane. I didn't marry his brothers. So the fact that used to be a tradition seems a little strange to me, but it was a different time, it was a different culture, and I understand that. But still, I can't imagine being married to a brother-in-law. So I'm grateful that some traditions change. No offense, guys. I love y'all, don't worry. But another thing that we hear from this reading is that our God is the God of the living, for to him all who are considered worthy of a place in the resurrection are alive. And that is the good news for today. But I wonder, and I admit, I don't always feel this way, but have you ever felt that when you're in a worship service and you're sitting there in a sanctuary, do you ever feel that it's not just those people who are gathered there who are worshiping, but that we also praise God with believers that we can't even see. Or like when we celebrate Holy Communion, do you feel like we feast with believers from the past, the present, and the future? I don't always think about that. But that is the communion of saints. The entire community of believers. We commune with Christians around the world. And with believers who came before us and have passed on to their heavenly reward. And with believers who will come after us. We all belong to the communion of saints. And quite often, even in today's culture, we think of saints as those really, really, really good people. Like Mother Teresa. I've never heard anybody say a bad word about Mother Teresa. Or Saint Francis of Assisi. Nobody's around anymore to say bad things about him. But we think about these, you know, saintly, saintly isn't the word I'm looking for, these perfect people. But you know what? The Bible tells us that a saint is a follower of Jesus Christ. That's the definition of saint. Followers of Christ become saints by being born again by the Holy Spirit, which can only happen through God. These saints were called. They were holy, and they were dedicated, but they were still real people, far from perfect people. The first followers of Jesus were fishermen, and you know that when they went fishing and they cast their nets into the water, and it got stuck on a rock at the bottom of the lake, and they're pulling, and they rip the net, and all the fish go out. Urgh! You think maybe they said a bad word or two? Yeah. I bet they did. There were also farmers who followed Jesus. What if there was a horrible, horrible year of growth and their harvest was piddly? Maybe they shook their fists to heaven and yelled at God. Maybe if one of them was a carpenter, they smashed their thumb with a hammer. It's hard to not say a bad word when those things happen. It's hard to not have anger and feelings when that happens. And yet, God still called them saints. They weren't perfect by any stretch of the imagination. Yes, they said bad things. Sometimes they still did bad things. But they were still saints. Just like us, they were on a journey. The journey of following Jesus. The journey of learning to be more and more like Him. Which means becoming more and more loving and more accepting of others. Jesus is perfect. But Jesus' followers, you know, we are far from perfect. I mean, just think about all of the mistakes that Saint Peter made. He followed Jesus in the flesh for 3 years. And at the end, on the very last night that he was with Jesus, before he was arrested or as he was being arrested, Peter cut off a man's ear. And Jesus had to correct him and say, "No, Peter, that isn't how we do things." See, Jesus knew that none of us would be perfect. Even those who received kind of on-the-job training as they were with Jesus in the flesh, day in and day out for 3 years. They learned as they followed Jesus, and they learned from their mistakes by allowing Jesus to forgive them and accepting his forgiveness and then moving on in his love. Now just think about how radically we, as Christ's followers, are called to live. We are told to love our enemies, to do good to those who hate us, to bless those who curse us, and to pray for those who mistreat us. We are called to be compassionate just as God is compassionate. But it is not easy. In worship today, I used this example. I said, now, say you accidentally cut somebody off in traffic and they respond by maybe blaring their horn at you and using a hand gesture with one of their fingers to show you just how displeased they are with your imperfection. You don't want to throw back that same finger at them, do you? Okay, you do. Maybe you do. But followers of Jesus, we saints, are told to bless those who curse us. So give them a little sign of the cross. Blessings on you, and please forgive me for my imperfection. Anybody ever done that? I haven't. I'm afraid they'd misconstrue what I was doing. But even though we're imperfect, God still calls us saints. Now the word saint, all the words in both Greek and Hebrew that are used in the Bible for the word saint have the same definition. A saint is someone who is holy, pure and blameless, and dedicated. And the word holy doesn't mean perfect. I always thought it did, but it doesn't. Holy means set apart to serve God. And we, as saints, are only pure and blameless through the blood of Jesus, which washes away the stain of our sin. And a saint is also dedicated, because we saints do stumble and we fall down, but we get back up again. Yes, we may fall into sin and lose our temper and hurt someone or ourselves by our words or actions, but we then ask God for that forgiveness. And we accept it, and we ask God for the strength to grow in love. When we recognize the communion of saints, we acknowledge that our faith community stretches far beyond time and space, because the communion of saints is when we commune with Christians around the world, but also with believers who came before us and with believers who will come after us. and we continue to live the righteous life by doing the will of God in our lives, by following Christ's teachings and sharing those teachings with others. It is how we live that out in our daily lives. That is how God makes us think. And it's how His light shines through each and every one of us. So all of you saints, I pour blessings out on you. You are all in my prayers. And thank you for spending this time with me again. God bless.